say this, Ricky Byram's brother Gerald passed away yesterday, and just remember to keep him in your prayers, the family, and so just wanted to say that before we get started. Liam, go to the prayer.
Dear Heavenly Father God, Lord, let us thank you for granting us this day today, God. Thank you for letting us live in a country where we can have a democracy and have council people to run the city, God. I pray that you give them wisdom and guidance, Lord, give them strength to make the right choices and decisions, God. God, I pray for Bishop Byram and his family, Lord God, give them peace and rest with their loss, God. We just pray that you watch over us and guide us and protect us through this day. All these things we pray in Jesus Christ, so we have amen.
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 Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Gerald's funeral, that visitation is tomorrow from 2 to 3 for the family, and then from 3 to 9 for the visitors. And the funeral will be Saturday at 2 o'clock, and it's at W.T. Wilson's. So, we can announce that to you. All right, we'll go ahead and get started. Marshall?
I concur with Marshall. I don't need
it. All right.
Wow.
Bijan?
Y'all don't want to let me talk. First of all, on the Chevy's Bridge update, it's about 95% done, and they got a little bit more paving to do, stopping. And also on September 12th, we have a crew coming from Montgomery that they check the bridges before they put the traffic on. So after they do the inspection, and hopefully, if you know, everything goes well, should have it open at the end of the month. So I just wanted to update on Chevy's Bridge. The other bridge we got is the Bruiser Bridge that we've been working on it to get it let. We had the lowest bid last month, but it was almost $100,000 over the budget. So we went back to the drawing table and we cut it back to 327. We got three bids. We came in this week. I'll go ahead and read it to you. The first one is Gillespie Construction. The bid was $320,066. Sam Construction was $334,805. And Lambert Contracting is $362,013. So therefore, we're going to award the contract to Gillespie Construction. I'm going to read that up tonight. I'll go ahead and their budget, and we'd have to add another $86,000 for the engineering and other costs that we cut back that we won't do it ourselves. So that's one of the items I have to bring up tonight. The other one I got is we have several old computers in the library, and there's 601 and one printer. We're going to have a resolution, resolution 95-2019 to surplus the items. And also, there is a laptop that's just been in the basement sitting there for a long time. And we don't need it, so we're going to surplus that too. So I'm going to add that to resolution, KDP. We're going to put that in there.
If anybody wants to
view
it, go online, check it out.
The problem is gold. If it's silver, I'll be interested.
Thanks.
Yeah. All right. And we have a culvert on Country Club Lane and Everett Street that has already been placed and is the paving be done over those culverts. The total paving is $3,900. I'll bring that to you tonight. And most of these culverts that we paved now, and it's it's a head wall. It's just that concrete that goes on the end of it, keep it from erosion. And there's eight of them, and the price is about $7,000. So I'll bring that up.
We had a couple things to bring up, Mayor. First thing we're going to bring up is accept Larry Trailer's resignation from the Industrial Development Board. He sent Larry in, he's wanting to be taken off the board. The next thing is our animal control officer, we have to send her to get certified within, I believe, it was 6 months. And this is pretty much the deadline. If we go ahead and do it, it's a little bit cheaper. For September 20th, and it's $500, and we're going to pull that out of our place savings fund. We pull that out of that to let her do that. A couple things, one more thing, and we can wait until the next council meeting, we can do it tonight. We always do the fire prevention for October. It's $2,000. If we're going to go ahead and do it tonight, I'd like to bring it up. That way we can be done with it for the fire department, fire prevention program in October.
Yep.
I got two things that Councilman Byron asked me to bring up. One of them was to set a street light pole, street light and a pole on the intersection of Horton and Kurt. I believe the pole will be around $300. So I'm gonna go ahead and bring that to you guys tonight. The next thing is he also wanted to bring up the microphone system for the council and court chamber. The court will be paying $1,320, and the city will be paying $480. That's to have the microphone system here so everybody can hear, and also the court.
So about $2,000.
So I'll be bringing that up tonight, too.
You definitely need that.
It's actually $1,800. Yeah, it's $1,800. So I'll be bringing that to the table tonight, too. Other than that, that's pretty all we got, Mayor.
Okay.
Everything's going well in the police department. We are, Chief Wright and I are going to be hosting a 9/11 memorial on the morning of 9/11. So we'll start at 8:30 in the morning at the memorial, along with the first responders memorial. We'd like to invite the public, and of course you guys, to be there if you can. We feel strongly about 9/11, obviously, in our profession, and this country was attacked cowardly, and we need to remember those who take that ultimate price. So we'd ask that everybody be there that can be.
What time do you say, Chief?
8:30 in the morning at the first responders memorial.
What day is it? Wednesday. The 9/11. So we'd like to invite y'all. Other than that, that's not the only thing we're going to the police department right now. So thank you. Surprise. Everything's good in the fire department. We're starting to gear up the fire prevention month in October. So see about 1,000 kids doing fire prevention and things like that. But that's about it. Everything's going well.
Thank you. Sir.
We've been doing a lot of summer cleaning. Can't see getting rid of some of the old computers, some of them bad hard drive. They're pretty much unusable. We did have a issue with one of our air conditioning units in the children's area. It's in the ceiling. So they're in that really hot stable. It got too hot up there. And the pipe was stopped up, so we didn't have a leak in there. The power refrigeration did come and fix that. So hopefully we're good to go now.
Okay.
I forgot to bring this up on the library, Chief. The two entrance signs where it says enter and exit, it's been there a long time. One of them, I think I noticed, was bended. Looks like somebody just homemade it and put it there. So anyway, I ordered the two new signs to go down there on the entrance, and it was under $700. I just want to let you all know that there's two new signs going to be put up.
Same.
Everything's good with
chamber.
Everything's good?
Everything's good.
Have you say anything else about the bridge?
Nothing much. I don't know, our bids were, I think it was 75,000 less than our bid last time, our low bid. So that was good. And we got it down as low as we can go there in three bids, so.
Do you know the timing on the going start?
I don't know yet. It'll be, it'll probably take around a month to get awards sent and bonding and insurance back, and then pre-construction conference and all that. And from there, it'll kind of be, you know, we'll try to be a little bit flexible in their schedule as to what, you know, exact day they'll begin. But, you know, it'll be probably at least a month before they get started moving dirt, so.
Since it's calendar day, should we just wait till next year, or what do you think?
We can. I think it'd be a good conversation to have with them when we sit down and kind of get all the paperwork done and the awards ready. We can kind of sit down with them and work on a schedule and see, you know, kind of what works for everybody. Because there's no point saying they're going to start, you know, 1st of October if they're not going to be there for a month.
Okay.
You know, we can kind of work that with them depending on when. You know, they're moving like everybody else. They're moving from one job to the next. So, you know, there's no point in sending one or two guys out there to scratch around and make it look like they're doing something until they're ready to actually come and get started. So.
How many days did you have?
It's 120, I believe. I think that's correct.
We'll start October 1st, we'll say November 1st. November, December, January, February. By February, end of February, they should get it finished. Do you think they can work on that for a month?
It's 120. Yeah, the big thing is going to be the first, you know, the first 30 days. Within the first 30 days, they actually should be able to get it up out of the bottom of the stream bed. And then once they do that, they can kind of work, even if they've got some water going through, because everything's going to be up above it, as long as they don't get, you know, really, really large.
Well, they can ship that water from barrel to barrel.
Yes. And I hadn't asked them how, we kind of left that up to them as to how they wanted to divert the water. I think some had looked at pumping it. Most likely, they'll probably sandbag it and divert it, would be my thoughts. Divert it through half while they're, to get one barrel done, and then, or at least get it up out of the ground, then shift it over to this barrel to send it through the other one. And that way, they don't actually have to run pumps, pumping it around the structure.